Well, good morning, everybody, and welcome to our online Sunday school. It's good to have you all with us. This morning, we're going to look at another parable. The last 2 weeks, we've looked at two parables, and we're going to look at another parable that Jesus taught, and we're going to look at the parable of the sower, or some people call it the parable of the soil. In our reading today in Matthew, and it's also interesting to note, this same parable is also mentioned in Mark and in Luke. Jesus spoke of a farmer who sowed seed on his land. Jesus taught this parable. He spoke of four different types of soil. The first soil he spoke is often referred to as the wayside, or we may call it like a footpath, where the ground would be hard and where people would walk on it regularly. So we see that some seed fell on by the wayside. The next type of soil is what is called stony ground, and we see some of the seed fell on the stony ground. The next type of soil is the thorny soil, soil which is covered in weeds and things like that. So some of the seed fell among the thorns, it said, or among the weeds. And then the fourth soil is the good ground. We read that Jesus said that the seed fell on good ground. So we've got the four types of soil where the seed fell on. We've got the wayside footpath, the hard ground. We've got the stony ground. We've got the thorns and the weeds. Then we've got the good ground. Then the Bible tells us in the story of this parable what happened to the seed, what fell on these different types of soil. The seed, what fell on the by the wayside, was soon cleared up by the birds. You can see the birds pecking away, and they soon devoured all the seed. So there was no seed and no plants grew on that at all. The next type of soil is the stony soil. We see here that the seed grew. You can see this, some of the seeds, the plant still there. But when the sun came up and it got very, very hot, because there was no depths of soil and it was very hard, rocky land, well, you can see the plant soon withered away and died. Then we come to the seed, what fell among the thorns. You can see what's happened here. The seed fell among the weeds, as we saw in our first illustration. But the weeds grow a lot quicker and the thorns grow a lot quicker than what the plants do. You can see in here an odd plant which has started to grow, but as the weeds get bigger, the thorns get bigger, they smother the good crops out. And the final soil was the good soil. We see here how the seed what fell on good soil, it grew, it all came up and it all grew. And it says in the Bible, some produced 30-fold, some 60 and some 100. Well, I'm going to explain that to you a little bit later. But you can see on the good soil how the crops grow very, very well. When Jesus spoke in parables, some of the parables he spoke, he explained the meaning of. Others he didn't. He left it for people to work it out for themselves. But this particular parable, Jesus did explain the meaning of it. The meaning of this parable is talking about the seed. And the seed, it doesn't say in the book of Matthew, but in the book of Luke, it said the seed is God's word. So when the seed is sown, when you come to Sunday school, we would call that the people who teach you would say it's like sowing seed. You hear about the word of God, you hear about stories from the Bible, and you hear what the Bible teaches us. So it's like sowing seeds. So the four types of soil we were looking at today explains what our hearts are like when we hear God's word spoken to us. When we learn it perhaps at Sunday school, what effect does it have on us? Now the first type of soil we saw was the wayside, the hard, rocky, like a footpath, where the soil, where the seed fell on there, and we soon saw that as soon as it fell on there, the birds came and pecked all the seed up. So it didn't grow at all. Now, this, Jesus explained, was like people who hear God's word. When they listen to God's word, when they listen to the stories from the Bible, it doesn't have any effect on them at all. And no sooner do they hear the word of God, and it is just forgotten. Nothing grows, nothing happens at all. The seed is just taken away and nothing grows. The second soil we heard was the stony soil. Well, you see from the stony soil that the seed does grow, but it soon, when the difficulties arise, it soon withers away. And that is just like how some people, the word of God means to some people, that it starts to grow, they hear God's word, and as it says in the Bible, they receive it with joy. It means something to them. But when difficulties arise, them difficulties may be many things, that they soon forget about it and they soon give up on God's word. It may be that if you come to Sunday school, your friends may make fun of you for coming to Sunday school, and that would be a difficulty what would arise, and you don't like being made fun of, and you soon forget God's word. So when difficulties arise, that is what happens when the seed falls on rocky soil. So that's what Jesus was saying. When the seed fell on the rocky soil, because there was no depth of soil, it couldn't put its roots down. And it had to, and it, as soon as the sun got up, it soon withered away. Then we come to the soil which was full of weeds and thorns, the thorny soil, as it says in the Bible. Well, you can see from the thorny soil that some of the corn, again, some of the plants, they did grow, but as I said earlier, the weeds tend to grow a lot faster, the thorns grow a lot faster than the grain or the plants. So what this means is that, again, like on the seed what was sown on the stony soil, that the seed grew and started to grow, but the weeds soon, as we would say, overtook them. And that's what happens to a lot of people. When they hear the word of God, when they hear God's word spoken to, when they hear God's word read, again, it means something to them. They receive it with joy, but things soon start to crowd out their lives. Other things soon become more important. It may be you like sport or football, and reading God's word may keep you from doing some of these other things. So that maybe that's just one example of where other things can come into your life and become more important than God's word. It may be you like other things. There are so many things which can easily distract us and draw us away from God's word. So that is what Jesus was saying when he spoke about the seed what fell among the thorns. Other things soon became far, far more important than the word of God. But the final soil we saw was the good ground. And we see from this story, from this example, the good ground, how the seed grew, and it said some produced 30, some produced 60, and some 100-fold. Now, what does this mean? What did Jesus mean when he said this? So when Jesus said some produced 30, some 60, and some 100-fold, I'll try to explain to you what he meant. Now, I've got some examples in front of me here. Now, all these plants came from one seed. So we've got one here which just produced one ear of wheat. Now, that would probably, there probably would be about 30 grains of corn in that. We've got another one here which produces, you've got four ears of wheat. Again, you can see from there, it just come from one, from it came from one seed. So that would have probably produced 60 or maybe a bit more. Then we've got another one here, which produced six ears here. You can see again, it came from one seed. Now I've got one particularly special one here, which produced a lot more ears of wheat, and that would probably produce 200 fold. So that's what Jesus was saying, that when one seed is sown on good soil, like we see here, that it may produce one ear, 30 fold, it may produce 60 or more, or even it could produce a lot more. So what does he mean by this? Well, what Jesus is saying here, that some Christians are more fruitful than others, that they may be more able and willing to serve God in different ways. Maybe because they have more time, they may have more opportunity. But the most important thing is that if we're Christians, that we are fruitful. So just one, before I end, I'd just like to ask one question. We talked about the four types of soil, the wayside soil, the thorny ground soil, the stony soil, and the good soil. Now we have to look to ourselves and say to ourselves, when we hear God's word, when God's word is read to us, when we go to Sunday school and hear God's word, what does it mean to us? Does it fall on the, are our hearts like the wayside soil? Are they like the stony ground soil? Are they like the soil which is full of weeds and thorns? Or is it good soil? Well, I do trust that when you hear God's word, it always falls on good soil, and that you will all be very, very fruitful in your lives.